Now we will look into RAC awareness. Okay, so we will see what is RAC awareness and how to implement by using Cloudera Manager. So as we said, RAC awareness is nothing but the specifying the network topology to the cluster. Okay, so we will provide the information to the cluster, such as on which RAC or which data center our hosts are or servers are located. And cluster will take the decisions by using, based on this information, by using the script which is stored inside the cluster. So it looks into the performance and the resilience factor, and also based on the data that we provide. So HDFS mainly store the data by looking in this factor. So it use the script and the data. So here I will show you how to implement that RAC awareness and how to provide that information by using Cloudera Manager. So assigning RAC is very simple. So go to the host, like all host. Okay, say for example, two of my nodes are in first RAC and the remaining nodes are in another RACs. Okay, so we can see that information, RAC information here. I think you can add that option, RAC also here. Okay, so by default, initially it shows everything as default. So say for example, I have two nodes, so which is on the same RAC. So RAC is nothing but a unit. So all the servers are inside the RAC. It has its own networking and power supply and other RACs also. So we may have multiple RACs involved in a very big cluster. So you need to specify on which RAC the node belongs to and which RACs the other nodes belongs to. So the cluster will take the decisions for placing the HDFS blocks and submitting the jobs. It consider these factors. So where our nodes are located. And also it looks into the performance and resilience factor. So before placing the blocks or before submitting the map or reduce task. So from our side, what we need is we need to specify or tell the cluster, okay, so these nodes are on this particular racks and the other nodes are on particular racks. The rack name is the one which we use. Like you can use any name. So for identifying one rack, say for example, normally we use slash followed by some name. So assign rack, so click that. So I'm just using it, then my name is rack01, confirm it. And I use the other one, so other two machine also, then assign rack, then. Because the failure, the node failure also, similar to the node failure, there is a chances for rack failure also. There may be the interruption to power supply to particular rack, or maybe interruption to network to that particular rack. So if you design your cluster well and place in different racks and give that information here. So even in the failure of one rack, so your cluster will be up and running and that will be in operational condition. So the assigning rack is very simple. Select the host. So go to the all host, then configure, then all host, then select the host that you want to change, then assign rack. So that's it for assign rack assignment. So once that is done, there may be certain services you need to redeploy. So just click that, then restart stale configuration. Okay. I will show you before enabling racks how it looks like. So you can go to slash var run Cloudera SCM agent, then process. So check that name node directory. Okay, so the latest name node directory. So this is the one. Then go inside that. Then you can see one file. Okay, so topology.map and topology.dat. topology.map, this is a file. Okay, so this is one XML file which tell okay, so on which rack this machine belongs to. Okay, so we have two options. One is with the host name and IP, and this is the data file. Topology.map is the file which is generated by Cloudera Manager, and it our jobs as well as the HDFS uses this file and topology.py Python script to identify on which rack it belongs to. Okay, so initially everything is belongs to the default rack, so that is why it's showing us default. And topology.py is the Python script. And if you want to know on which rack this particular IP or a particular IP belongs to, you can use this. So that will print the rack. Also, if you want to know this one, okay, so it will print the rack. So in backend, our HDFS and yarn jobs use this script and data files to do the operation. So now I have changed that. So I'm just doing a restart now. Okay, so now all the services are restarted. So now we will go to this backend slash var run lsf and lrt. And we will see that. Okay, so since we did this redeploy, so you can see something like that. So go to this directory and yeah, inside that I can see topology.map file. I think I need to restart the services once. -lrt grep. Okay, so let me check this directory. Topology.map. Yeah, so this is the latest directory. So topology.map. So in this directory, you can see the file topology.map and topology.py. So for each machine, so the whatever the rack we have assigned, that is updated in this XML file. So if you use this one, and okay, so you want to find out on which machine, which rack this machine belongs to, it is printing. So if you want to know on which rack this particular machine belongs to, it will print as rack 2. So our HDFS and MapReduce use this script and this data to find out on which machine, which rack this belongs to. And also it take that decision based on this information. So it consider the performance and resilience factor. So before placing the blocks or before submitting the jobs into that particular nodes. So this is how rack awareness works. So we need not to do anything on the backend. So everything we can do from the Cloudera manager, go to the host, all host, then assign the rack here. So we can assign the rack name here. So normally rack name with slash rack followed by the rack name. So that's it about the rack awareness. So so if you like the contents, so please like, also please subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Bye.